Well, the new iPhone will hit stores on Friday, and Apple is making some big claims about its new cameras. Well, to help us make sense of it all, it is a very good morning to Image Matrix tech editor Djuro Sen. Djuro, good morning to you. So, well, apparently the iPhone 15 Pro Max is one to buy not only for photography but for video.
That is right. Good morning to you, Janie. Yes, the 15 Pro Max is the one to buy, and that's because it has a bit more room to fit some really special lens technology. So if you're into video or you're into shooting the family in terms of capturing memories, those sorts of things with photos as well, then the 15 Pro Max is the way to go. And they've been able to do this, squeeze like 120 millimetres into the back of the camera, and they do it with a tetraprism design, and that just sort of reflects the light up to four times, and that extends the reach. It makes it look like it's a longer lens, and in fact it does. And really what Apple's saying here is that you've got seven lenses in your pocket, because you can go from macro right up to 120 millimetres, the equivalent. What does that mean? It's like a big camera lens. So it is quite amazing how much they've done. And for many people, this will replace the traditional camera, if it hasn't already. For me, I use it as well. Photographers as well, using that new USB-C port, as everyone talked about, Joni, will be able to connect to a computer and do professional photography just like they do in a studio. So all these aspects to it are incredible. They've even filmed a music video as well that they showed off. And this thing is pretty good. I mean, if you saw this video, you wouldn't even know it was shot on an iPhone. And I often use the iPhone for production, and I just sneak it in there and people have no idea. Also, very shortly, you'll be able to use your camera for spatial video. So you know the big headset that they talked about, the Apple Vision Pro? Well, you'll be able to shoot stuff very shortly, family members in that immersive video. So you can get all those videos under your belt, and then later on when the headset eventually comes out, you'll be able to put the headset on and enjoy the family experience. And I've got to say, this app from Blackmagic Design, this is incredible. So this is a Blackmagic camera app. Try it out. It's free. It turns your iPhone into a professional-looking camera, and it uploads the video into an already set-up editing session on DaVinci Resolve. That's the editing software. This is really cool. It's free. Try it out. So, and you don't have to use the new phone. You can try it on your iPhone 14 if you want, but that's the new Blackmagic camera app. I know some of the guys are at Sky keen to try it out as well.
Yeah,
so
absolutely.
Lots of stuff in there, Janie.
I'll tell you what, yeah, well, we've come a long way in tech world, haven't we? And a lot of people talking about the new iPhone USB-C connector as well. Mm. Why is that?
Yes, well, it's about time, I guess. We know that the EU are pushing the design for Apple to become part of the USB-C fraternity, and it makes sense. So before you go out and rush all these sorts of products which are USB-C and the demise of the Lightning port, which has been around for a long time, you have to realise that there's a couple of things happening here. In the original iPhone, or the iPhone 15, the base model, you're getting basically 2.0 speeds. So you've got the shape of the actual plug, which is USB-C, and then USB 3 and above is the speed that gets up to 10 gigabits per second, or 20 times the normal speed. USB-C 2.0 is just 480 megabits a second. So that's really fast. Apple already do this with the iPad and their MacBooks, so they're used to doing it, Janie, and I think this is a great move. So you just got to realise you've got to get the right cable if you get the Pro models to get the maximum speed.
Yep, lots of cables there. Now, as we head into the fire season, a timely reminder, isn't it, Djuro, that we really need to update our apps and also air filters, smoke alarms, you name it.
Yeah. Well, if you're like us, Janie, you live in Sydney, you've had a lot of smoke around the area for good reason, because hazard reduction burns are very important, but it does play havoc with our lungs. Now, the thing that you've got to do is update your phone apps. Fires near me, I remember trying this just before the big fires a couple of years ago, and it was really important to keep you safe, because connected to the GPS on the phone, you're able to then realise, okay, a fire is near me. Now, that's not the only app either for the New South Wales people. You can also have a thing that's called Hazards Near Me, and that brings in all sorts of things like floodings. But I noticed in the fires near me, that showed me some fires up in Queensland, but the hazards near me didn't do that. I've had a look around in the other states, so make sure you try your emergency services, check them out, and if you see Obviously, the first indication is all that smoke around that's going to tell you there's a fire. And this was the case in Sydney the other day when I was in the centre of town. So I've been trying this out. This is a Dyson, big and quiet. It's an air purifier. Make sure you check your filters, because once they get clogged, they're not going to do a great job. Now, this is new from Dyson. It's about $1,500, but this thing actually is a beast. It projects air about 10 metres. And I tried it out yesterday, the last couple of days, and I had a lot of bad stuff in the air. It's now proceeded to clean it up. But it really rammed home to me how important it is to clean the filters out. This is another model I have. I love these fans. I reckon it's the best thing they do. And that's been full. That red light is not good. It means I've got to change the filters on the fan. Once you do that, you can get all the nasties out of your house, the stuff from the stove, and also the particulate matter that comes in from bushfires, some of it that you can't see. At night, I particularly noticed the smoke. I think it might have been because of the inversion layer, but make sure you check out your filters too with those sorts of devices, that one from Dyson.
All right, well, great advice, and it's always great to see you, Djuro. We'll see you again soon.
Thanks, Janie, and a shame about our roosters.
Oh, I didn't want to talk about that. God, how was the end there? It was incredible.
I know. Yeah, no, it was good to watch.
Yep, 2024, here we come. Thanks, Djuro.